to this new role began several months ago when Steve and I were talking about what would be our best contribution to this organization, the Great Commission, and for the next 3 to 7 years. And we thought we heard an answer in November. And we thought that answer was to reduce the number of people that were reporting to Steve and to move down in the organization so that younger leaders could lead. Well, obviously, we weren't listening very well, or God was testing our faith, because in January, we had a couple undistracted days away at the beach. We did a lot of talking and praying. And at that time, I feel like the Lord put this thought into my head, which I shared with Steve. And it was that, you know, I've given 44 years of my life to Campus Crusade and Crew. You've given 42. I want to make sure that we're the best stewards of what God has entrusted to us thus far and the relationships that he had developed more in the global arena. And that was kind of a change of direction in my own heart and thinking, and Steve felt a lot the same way. He felt a release and was able to communicate that to Steve Douglas, who was pretty excited about that. Because there were other meetings that were going on with the board that we weren't really aware of. But through the last 3, 4, 5 months, I guess it's been now, God has been confirming that that is his call for us. And for me, it's also been a careful confirmation. And it's been kind of sweet because it's felt kind of like going back to my initial call on staff. And the verse in 1 Thessalonians 5:24, which most of us claimed, has been very special to me. And in this translation, I love how it says, the one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. And that's the only way I feel like I can step into partnering with Steve on this.
So when Christy, we were at the beach, we were praying and taking extended time with the Lord and time with each other, and when she started having the sense that maybe we were headed in the wrong direction by starting to start moving back down into the organization and shrinking our scope, I was sensing the Lord saying, I want you to be open to whatever I have for you to do, not what do you want to do. And so as an executive team, we met in January and we're talking about this whole structural arrangement. And then Steve made his proposal to the board of how he wanted to move forward in February. And the board approved what Steve wanted to do. And so Steve and I had conversations about would I be willing to do this. And so anytime you're asked to do a new role, I know all of you are like me, that your obvious approach is to go to the Lord and ask for wisdom and say, Lord, what would you have us do? Well, and as I started to do that, the first day, I started just my prayer, Lord, you know, I've been asked to do this new role. You know, what is your will? What would you have me do? And it was as if the Lord just would stop me in mid-sentence and say, I do not want you to ask for direction. I want you to pray prayers of surrender. So it's like, okay, Lord. So, you know, you kneel down and you pray prayer of surrender. Lord, I'm surrendered to whatever you want to do. I will do whatever you want me to do. Now, what direction do you want to give me? And it was like he would say, no, I want you to pray prayers of surrender. So one day led to 2 days, led to a week, led to multiple weeks, many weeks, where I had no freedom at all to pray and ask God for wisdom. And Christy would every now and then say, should we be talking about whether we should do this role or not? And I'm like, I got nothing. That all the Lord is saying is pray prayers of surrender.
So weren't we taught for the pro-con list, you know, the John Paul Brown list?
John Paul Brown, yep. So there was no pro-con list. It was just this constant praying, Lord, I'm surrendered to whatever you want. And that was where I stayed for weeks and weeks and weeks. And then eventually the Lord led us into Colossians, and we were reading Colossians 1, a familiar passage. And the Lord was saying that pray that you'd be filled with the knowledge of his will so that you may walk in a manner worthy of the Lord. To please him in every in every respect, bearing fruit in all things, and it goes on. And it was this sense of moving from praying prayers to surrender, just praying, Lord, would you be so kind to allow us to walk in a manner worthy